Hello, good evening. How are you today? Hi, hi.
Hello, good evening.
Hello. How are you?
Fine, thanks, and you?
Fine.
That is cold, no?
If it is cold.
Yes.
A little, not much.
Not too much.
Yesterday was a little cool.
Yes.
But today, not much.
A little.
Just a little. Just a little. No, yesterday was kind of. But today, yes.
In here, yes, it's a little cold. Most yesterday.
Today is colder than yesterday in the watch band?
Yes.
Really? Wow. Mm-hmm. I hear nothing. It's like kind of now that I remember, I don't know where it left my phone. Let me see. I guess I will be able to share, right?
Yes.
Okay. Well, let's check attendance. Ana Alicia.
Presente.
Excellent. Angel. Benjamin.
Presente.
Carolina. Carolina. Voy a dejar calladitos porque no es mucho. Okay. Let's see. Vaya, Carolina. No here. Daniela María. Daniela. David Alexander.
Present teacher.
Nice. Edwin Orlando. Edwin Orlando. Grace Michel, Aide de la Paz, Aide, Isabel, Jonathan,
Noches, teacher.
Present, teacher.
Jonathan, okay.
Present Isabel también.
Oh, okay. Vamos a ver. Isabel here. Jonathan here.
Yes.
Hey, teacher. Sí.
Oh, okay. Juan Antonio.
Yes.
Ajá. I heard somebody was talking. No. Juan Antonio. Karen.
Present teacher.
Nice, Karen. Marina. Marina Vanessa. Marina. No. Marlene.
Present teacher.
Nice. Rosa Hilda.
Present.
Nice, Rosa Hilda. Teresa de Jesús.
Present, teacher.
That's nice. Martínez Esquivel. Walter. Walter. No here, Walter. No. Yuri. Yuri.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Alexandra. Aristides. Yes, Isabella, I saw you. Okay, Aristides. You here, Brenda? Brenda. Who's Mauricio?
Present.
Teresa del Carmen. Teresa. Yancy.
Present.
Okay. Voy de regreso por si ya llegaron los que me faltaban. Teresa del Carmen. Brenda. Aristides. Walter. Marina. Juan Antonio. Aide de la Paz. Grace. Edwin. Daniela. Dani. Daniela. Carolina. Carolina. Carlos Ernesto. Ya. Yeah. Benjamín.
Present.
Yes. Okay. Ángel.
Present.
Okay. Nice. Nice, nice. Yes, Jonathan. Okay, perfect. Perfect, perfect. Well, let's start then. Okay. Vamos a la clase número qué. Vamos a ver.
Number nine.
Number nine. ¿Qué significa eso?
Midterm.
¿Qué significa que vayamos en la clase number nine? En la plataforma, todo tiene que
midterm
estar.
Midterm exam.
Ah. Oh. Yes, Ángel. Eso significa que en la plataforma todo tiene que estar completado hasta la unit, hasta el ejercicio 9, right? Y que el lunes tienen que completar el midterm exam, right? El midterm exam que va, ya lo voy a ir a vigilar, fíjense, porque hoy no he entrado a vigilarlos y vamos a ver cómo vamos. Porque así ustedes pueden aprovechar el fin de semana para adelantar si me deben mucho. Vamos a ver. Let's see, let's see. Aquí aprovechando pues que vamos al fin de semana. Veamos cómo van. Ya les puse allí, ahí están los discussions, ¿verdad? Asegúrense también de ir completando los discussions de cada día. Ahí está hasta ayer. Muy bien, muy bien. Daniela. Daniela, Daniela. Benjamín.
Hi, teacher.
A ponernos al día con la plataforma.
Ok.
Ángel me debe la de ayer. David.
The discussion or the exam?
Ahorita estoy viendo los ejercicios del homework. El homework, está el homework número 8. Me le falta el de ayer. Benjamín, me le faltan dos. Carlos.
Teacher, pero ya lo hice. And homework is, we stop the payment. Stop it. As Andrew carry the box. Esa, ¿verdad?
No sé cuál le falta. Revise cuál le falta, pero yo lo que estoy viendo es el promedio y me aparece que le falta. Tiene el 60.
Uy, qué raro.
Sí, revise a ver cuál. A ver, a cuál. A veces lo que pasa es que no se le da submit, ¿verdad? Entonces ahí chequen. Carolina, me debe dos. Okay. Carita, me debe tres. Grace, me debe tres.
¿Cuál es tres, teacher?
No sé cuál es tres, solo estoy viendo el promedio ahorita. Revisen las tareas, qué es lo que me debe, ¿verdad? Vamos a
ver. ¿En cuál cuestionario vamos? ¿Qué número vamos?
Ocho. Ocho.
Ok.
Tienen que estar hasta el ocho completos. Luis Mauricio. ¡Ah! Luis Mauricio. Luis Mauricio. Qué barbaridad. Pues sí me debe un montón.
¿Verdad? Sí. Estoy de acuerdo. Pues sí, le debo.
Póngale ceros, teacher.
Ay, imagine.
No, aún no, porque no hemos llegado al lunes. El fin de semana me pongo al día.
Le estoy recordando ahorita porque, pues sí, vean, para que aprovechen el fin de semana, que se pongan al día y que el lunes solamente les falte lo mucho del lunes y el midterm.
Sí. Ay, sí, pero sí. El fin de semana me pongo al día.
A ver, Marlene, solo el día ayer, y Rosa Hilda también, el de ayer. Teresa, estamos bien, Teresa Jesús.
Teacher, yo solamente el de ayer, ¿o le debo algún otro más?
¿Quién es yo? Quiero ver.
David.
Ah, David. Es que como estoy mirando la plataforma, vamos a ver ahorita. Ya le dijo. David, uno le falta. David, bueno, aparte del de ahora, ¿verdad? Pero, ajá.
Ah, pues sería el de ayer, entonces. Uh-huh. Ok.
Yeah. Hola.
Hi, Benjamin.
Yo solo el de ayer le digo, te dice, me dijo que dos, pero solo estoy revisando y solo el de ayer tengo el día.
Fíjese, revise porque tengo 40%. 40% me le aparece a mí. Entonces cheque a ver.
Pero los que tienen el chequecito verde es que ya están subidos, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Entonces yo tengo subido hasta el número 7, solo el 8 es el que no he subido.
Teacher, puede revisar la mía. Ya le di submit a todo y todo me parecía ya subido hasta el 8.
¿Quién?
Yo, Ángel.
Vamos a ver, fíjese que. Benjamín. Benjamín, ¿sí? Solo me le aparece que ha hecho la 1 y bueno, la 6 y 7. La 8 no le aparece todavía, que es la de ayer.
Ajá, sí, la 8 no la he recibido.
No, espérenme.
Es la de ayer y no la pude.
Ah, pues ahí está. 8, 9, 10. La de ayer, la de hoy y la de lunes. Por eso es que tiene el 40%.
Ah, pues.
Ay, yo me había asustado. Yo dije, ¿a dónde se le fue? No, pues sí, está bien. O sea, solo le falta el de ayer. En el fin de semana pone de allí ya al día con la de ayer y con la de hoy. Para que el lunes solo le quede el midterm.
Teacher, Rosaila le habla. Me dice que me falta la de ayer, pero ya la hice y me aparece el chequecito.
Rosaila, déjame, me voy a ir de ríos. Vaya, no me puedo ir de uno en uno hoy. Porque si no, se nos va a ir la clase. Pero sí. Chequen siempre que le dan. Que le dan, ¿cómo se llama? Submit. Ángel. Le falta la de ayer. Rosa, ¿qué?
No, teacher, ya la hice. Ya le di submit. Rosa, ahorita. Irina. Le volví a dar submit.
No sabría, no sabría decirle a Ángel si es la de ayer o cuál es. Porque a mí me aparece ahorita el promedio. Tendría que irme a darle clic a su nombre para revisar cuál es la que le falta. Entonces, cheque, okay. Cheque a cuál de esta semana no le ha dado. No le ha dado submit.
Rosa. Bueno.
Rosaila. Si me falta la de ayer, bueno, supongo que es la de ayer, ¿no? Porque tiene el 60. Sí, la de ayer.
Ok, teacher.
No, la de hoy y la de lunes son, Rosailda. Son la de hoy y la de lunes las que le faltan.
Ok, teacher.
Está bien, está bien. O sea que ahorita, tienen que tener, si no, ahí tienen que tener hasta ahorita completado el 60%, ¿verdad? De la tarea de la semana. Porque van las 6, 7, 8, que es la de ayer, hoy la 9 y para el lunes la 10. ¿Verdad? Ajá, ¿estamos bien? Ay, ya me había asustado y la asusté. Pero sí, estamos bien. Ahí estamos en la tarea ahorita, es la tarea 8. Hasta la 8 tienen que tener completa. ¿Verdad? Yo ya hoy van por la 9 y el lunes van por la 10 y el examen. Oye, porque acuérdense que nuestro viernes es el lunes. ¿Verdad? Así vamos, ¿verdad? ¿Verdad que sí?
Yes.
Nuestro viernes es el lunes, porque el lunes cumplimos sesión 10. Toca sesión 10 y midterm exam. Entonces, por eso es que yo estoy molestando, ¿verdad? Porque estoy molestando para que no me les quede mucho para el lunes, porque el lunes les toca el midterm. Entonces ya eso les tomaría un poquitito más de tiempo.
Entonces, teacher, ahorita tendríamos que tener el 60% ganado.
60% de la unidad 2.
Sí, correcto.
Uh-huh.
Mm, sí, okay.
De la unidad 2. Ahí está muy bien. Y con la de hoy y la de lunes terminan el 100% de la unidad 2. ¿Verdad? O sea, es sesión 8 la que tienen que tener completada. Hoy la 9 y el lunes 10. Y el midterm exam que corresponde para lunes también. ¿Verdad? Ahí estamos. Ahí estamos muy bien. Okay. Bueno, I have a couple of questions for you here. Tell me, what's a small talk? Who knows what's a small talk? Mm-hmm. What's a small talk? Who has any idea?
Es una pequeña charla. Ajá. Es como una interacción o una pequeña, como le digo, charla de ideas, no sé, algo así.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, exactly. When you talk with people in an informal, right? In an informal way, just to talk. Just because you don't want to be sitting or standing next to the other and being quiet. That's why we need a small talk. Now tell me, do you consider yourself a good conversationalist? I will repeat this word, conversationalist. Hasta aquí, conversation. Say it, conversation. I don't hear you. Conversation.
Conversation.
Conversation. Say
conversation.
Conversation. Conversationalist.
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 Conversationalist. Yes. Do you consider yourself a good conversationalist? Yes.
In English, no, teacher.
Yes,
Ana. In English, no.
Hilda, no. No. Do you remember the phrase we were talking, we were using yesterday that was breaking the ice? Are you good at breaking the ice?
Yes.
Yeah? Yeah, I believe you. I
I don't know. I don't know. I in my case, yes.
Okay. Okay. What about the others? Are you good at breaking the ice? Do you remember what is break the ice?
Yes.
When you're the first one talking,
it's right? the start. The,
mm-hmm.
the conversation have... or another.
Okay, so we're the one who starts the talk.
Yes.
Even the other person is quiet, but you get there and you start talking and you start saying whatever.
Yeah.
Later on, we are going to talk about what are those important or what are those, can we say, topics that we use to start a small talk. Remember, a small talk is informal, right? That's informal, and we can use it to talk or to begin with something, right? We are in a place, we don't want to be quiet, so we start with that talk. Okay. Now I want you to know, to get to know these phrases, because we are going to be using during the class today. So we have breaking the ice. What is breaking the ice? Mm-hmm. Approaching someone you don't know and starting a friendly conversation with them. Right? That's a friendly, or that's breaking the ice.
Es como romper el hielo.
Exacto.
Cuando no conocemos.
Exactly.
Ajá. Cuando no conocemos a alguien y buscamos un tema para llegarle y no sé, entender cómo empezar una conversación.
Exactly. Exactly. Is it easy? What do you think? Is it easy to start a conversation?
Yes.
Okay, for some people, yes. Some others yes. Say like, no.
Okay. Just a big thing or they say.
Okay, yeah. Now check okay. The next word. We have the word private. What does it mean, private? What is private?
Private, someone who doesn't like to give away their personal information, opinions, or share their feelings.
Mm-hmm.
It's private.
Private, that's private.
Private.
Private, yes. Private. Sometimes it's, now with the time we're living, it's not so easy, right? To open and start giving all your personal information. So you unless you get to know the person a little bit or a friend introduce that person to you. If no, you go private, right? You go private. And that's why you will see the topics that we can talk later in a small talk. Now, rude. What does it mean, rude? Wants to.
Okay, rude. I manner or unpleasant.
Ill manner, right? Ill manner or unpleasant. So you say, ay, soy un enfermo, right? Somebody who's rude. So it's ill manner or unpleasant. So remember, we're talking about a small talk. So how are you going to break the ice and start a small talk? Be careful so you do not become rude, right? You have to be very, very careful. Okay, another word, phrase that we are going to be using is slipped. Slipped my mind. It's like when you forget something. Imagine you're talking with a person, but you don't remember suddenly. We do not remember the person's name, and it's like, in English, we have an advantage. We English teachers is that tell Mr. to people, right? So you can say, okay, nice to meet you, Mr. Mr. What? You don't remember, right? That, so you say, oops, it slipped my mind. That means I don't remember, I forgot it, right?
It's like when you go to the kitchen and says, what happened?
And you forget. You forget what you went to look for.
Yes.
Yeah, but that's a similar. But that will be a serious problem of memory, right?
Yes.
That remembering a person's name is like, we can say it's kind of common, especially if we're talking about a person who you do not know very well, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or you don't see very often. Mm-hmm. Then you say, it slipped my mind, so I don't remember. I forgot it, right?
We have
a small talk, checks. Small talk is a polite and informal conversation. Remember, it's informal. It's polite, but informal. Yeah, it is about things which aren't really important or meaningful. So you can talk about whatever. When meeting people socially, example, at a party. So you're in a party, you're in a conference, you're in a meeting, and you meet somebody, but you want to talk to that person, but in an informal way. So it's informal. Not rude, remember rude, right? But not rude. So you want to be polite and informal. Yeah? So some clues that people give, specialists, right? Give for you to remember somebody's name when you meet somebody for the first time is to say the name of the person many times, right? Many times, of course, be careful of appearing to be kind of okay. What word can we use here? So you repeat the person's name, but not too much either, right? So just to keep it in your mind a little bit. If not, the person will say, like, what's going on with this guy, right? So what's happening? Why is he so telling my name so many times? Okay, so you can say it, but always be careful. Now, because if no, you will make the person feel awkward, right? Awkward means feeling uncomfortable or embarrassed. When can you feel embarrassed when breaking the ice? Probably when somebody introduces his or her name to you and you don't listen to it very well. You don't listen to the name very well and you go like, oops, how can I ask the person for the name again if I didn't pay attention when the person gave me her name? Okay, so awkward, that's awkward. Repeat, awkward.
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 Awkward, that's feeling uncomfortable.
Awkward.
And embarrassed. Now, the last one, we have etiquette. Etiquette is a set of rules which indicate what acceptable behavior is in society. So there are some rules, right, on how to behave, how to talk to people. So that is etiquette. Yes? Etiquette. Okay, any questions about the vocabulary right now? No, yes?
Yes, teacher.
También, Rosa.
In etiquette, what's the mean behavior? Oh.
Behavior is comportamiento. Behavior. Comportamiento. El comportamiento en la sociedad. Recuerden que la sociedad nos dicta una serie de parámetros, ¿verdad? De comportamiento. Y ahí es donde nos dice que es polite, que es informal, que es formal, que es rude. Entonces, todo eso nos lo dicta la sociedad. Entonces, este behavior en inglés americano es sin U, en inglés británico es muy común, ¿verdad? Entonces, es estas 7 reglas que la sociedad nos dicta sobre qué es aceptable y qué no respecto al comportamiento se llama etiquette. Yes. Any other question over there? No question. No? Okay.
No question, teacher.
No questions. Nice. Okay, now we are going to move to this. This is some vocabulary that we are going to be using later on too. And what I want you to tell me here, to guess, what you think I'm talking about when I represent that represents that picture. What topic? What topics?
Food.
Here. What topic is it? Is this one?
For food.
Topics. What does it represent? When you see this, what does this represent?
City. Yes. Of directions.
Location.
Location about.
Yeah, so you went to the word, that's location, right? That's the location.
I see the name's Hershey. And I think
you got lost because you were thinking about
chocolate. The mouse, your mouse, I can see your mouse.
My mouse, no wrong.
Yeah, I see. What about if we say Hershey's? What is Hershey's?
Chocolate.
Chocolate with cookies.
Okay.
And food.
Food? What else? Could be Hershey's, could be Coca-Cola, could be
chocolate.
Any, I cannot tell you the word.
I'm not.
But that's the topic.
Company.
Yeah, somebody's cheating. No, yes, the company, right? That's the company. Nice. What about this one?
The president of the United States.
Uh-huh, president. What else? As a topic. Think about that topic for a small topic.
Discourse.
Mm-hmm. Anything else that comes?
Conference.
A conference, okay. Think about a topic, using it as a topic that you could use for a small talk.
Debate, but I don't know what to say.
A debate. Okay. What is that debate?
Competition.
Hmm. But can you take a competition as a topic for, I'm going to give you the first letter. The first letter is P.
Proposals
yeah.
for the government.
But government begins with G, and here we go with P. What can you think of? It finishes with this.
Proposals.
No, it's not proposals.
Persons, people.
Persons, people, no.
Teacher.
Politicians.
Kind of close.
Politics.
Politicians.
Politics.
Politics.
Politics. That's the topic. Politics. Yeah. Uh-huh. That's a topic for discussion. Okay. What about this one?
Camping.
Camping. Mm-hmm.
Runners.
Yeah.
Probably natural. Natural.
Nature.
Mm-hmm.
Events, teacher.
Events, yeah. That's one. Event. That's one of the words. What's the other one?
Competition.
It will begin with C, but it's not competition.
Athletics.
Yeah, it begins with C.
Competition event.
Conference.
Yeah.
Concert.
No, it's concert. A concert. It's a name.
Community. Community event.
Yeah.
Kind of close.
Environment.
No. No, it begins with
community event.
Kind of. I'm going to give you the next letter.
You see. You see.
Common event.
A common event. A common event can be an event where everybody can go, right? It's common to many people. Okay, let's see the next one. Hi, this is easy. Let's
travel.
Travel, yes. And the other is very easy too. What about this one?
Money,
yeah.
I say economy.
Okay, talking about money. Okay, what about this one?
Meaning work.
The first one?
Meaning work.
Yeah. Who are the people involved there? Who are the people involved?
This meeting.
Yeah, in the meeting, who are the people? Who are the people involved in the meeting?
Executive people.
Executives? Uh-huh. What else?
Exposition.
I'm going to give you the first letter.
I think they are art
business. Business?
Boss meeting.
Uh-huh.
Business meeting.
I'm going to give you the next letter.
Another letter.
Boss meeting. Boss meeting.
Bosses, yeah.
Bosses meeting.
Bosses meeting.
Boss in singular or bosses in plural, right? Bosses. Okay, what about this one?
Facebook.
Facebook.
Social.
Social media.
Influencers.
Okay.
Social networks.
Like.
Likes. Yeah. Likes. We can talk about likes and dislikes, right? Likes and dislikes.
Okay.
Now you have the words here. Okay. Now, what you're going to do this here, now that you know the meaning of each of them, right? Think about three good topics, or choose from there, three good topics for a small talk, and three topics you consider inappropriate. Repeat, inappropriate.
Inappropriate.
Okay, which are three topics that you consider good topics for a small talk? Three topics you consider good for a small talk. Locations. Is it a good topic for a small talk? Company. Politics. Common. Okay. Travel, bus, lights. Which of these topics? Choose three that you consider good for a small talk and three that you consider inappropriate for a small talk. Mm-hmm.
Inappropriate for me, you make a good morning.
Which will be inappropriate for you?
Excuse me, are you asking me something?
Yes, which ones do you consider inappropriate or which ones you consider good?
Making in your job inappropriate.
Which one? Choose from the topics you have here. You have location, company, politics, common event, travel, money, bosses, lights. Any place, right? Not only at work, but any place, with anywhere.
Like I said, are you making money in your job?
Money. Oh, okay. Sorry. This is good or bad?
Me.
What did you say, Anna? Sorry, I heard it a little cut. For you, it's good.
inappropriate.
Okay, so we're going to put a cross here. Okay. Are you making good money? It depends if the person is a very close friend, right? If that's a very close friend, probably. But if it's a person who you're meeting and you're going to break the ice with that conversation, it's like, no, right? Aha. What other topic do you consider inappropriate?
Talking politics.
Politics, definitely, definitely. It's a bad idea, right? Mm-hmm. Because you will always find somebody who doesn't share your ideas, right? Aha. Uh-huh. Any other?
Bosses, to me, this is inappropriate.
Uh-huh, what for, right? There are other topics to talk about. Okay, nice, nice, nice. Now, let's choose three good topics for a small talk. Which are three good topics for a small talk?
Likes, mm-hmm. is a good topic.
Yes. When you say likes, you can talk about activities or hobbies. You can talk about food. You can talk about, I don't know. Well, hobbies is very, gives you a lot to talk, right? Mm-hmm. Yes. You can talk about pets or animals in general. Yeah. Okay. Another.
Travel.
Travel, yes. Mm-hmm. What else?
Como un evento.
Como un evento? Okay. Yeah. Hey, are you enjoying the seminar? Yeah. The person can say like, No, what about you? Well, sure, of course. I'm enjoying it. I'm learning a lot. So nice. So we have good topics like common events, travel, and likes, right? And inappropriate, politics, money, and bosses. Okay, nice. Nice. And now I'm going to send you to the comments. You can go and discuss these questions with your partners. Okay. You go discuss these questions. So you ask the ones that you consider are good topics for a small talk, you go and ask your partners. Let me see, we have the, how many people? Okay, 16. Grace, do me a favor. Remember to put your name complete, please.
Okay, teacher. Es que esto siempre lo quita. Yo lo pongo al iniciar la clase, pero hoy me falló la aplicación. Y me sacó y lo tuve que volver a reiniciar y me volvió a poner solo un nombre, un apellido.
Ay, no, qué barbaridad. Ay. Vamos a ver, I'm going to send you in groups of three. Okay. One group of four and the others will be groups of three. There you go. Let's. Ready? Ready, ready? Yes, right?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. There you go. You have those questions in your manual, okay? Page 25. 25. Great.
Pues las clavan.
Okay. Okay, teacher.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to share
the page number 25. Okay.
Mm-hmm. We answer the questions. For the inappropriate or small talk, teacher?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
The six questions.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Question. Mm-hmm.
So you got it.
Va a compartir, Ángel.
Era así, si no mal me recuerdo.
Yes.
La teacher había puesto aquí politics. X and money and bosses. And common event, travel, and likes. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. So, let's begin. The politicians are a disaster. What do you think? Yes, inappropriate. I don't know. What do you think?
This politics is a disaster.
Yes. It's a disaster.
The topic is not appropriate.
Yeah, politics definitely not. If checking, there is a space over there in activity 3. That you can replace 3 other topics that you can talk about. Okay. So okay. If you say no, definitely politics, we cannot talk about politics. So as you are asking the questions to your partners, you can ask the other ones.
The word is the most common topic.
Play safe.
When you break the ice.
It's very hot today, right?
Yes. Then when they start the class and tell you for the weather, it's a call in a WhatsApp. Huh?
Definitely, that's the best one. Yes.
Ahí está.
Ahí viene la teacher.
Teacher.
Se alegren de verme.
Aquí estamos hablando de rabanita.
Vamos a adivinar de qué vamos a trabajar aquí.
Vamos a escoger los tres temas.
Sí, and discuss the questions. Ahí les dan unas preguntas. Ask the questions to your partners. Por ejemplo, si dijeron, bueno, money is not a good topic, right? But travel, yes. Does your job require a lot of travel? And you ask the questions to your partner. Entonces, discuten las preguntas de los topics que ustedes consideran que sí son buenos para conversar. ¿Verdad? Por ejemplo, politics dijeron, no, it's not a good idea. Entonces no se preguntan sobre politics, sino que discuten sobre los otros tres que dijimos, que dijeron ustedes o ustedes acá como grupo. De hecho, pueden escoger también los tres topics si ustedes piensan que no exactamente con lo que todo el grupo escribió, ¿verdad? O si no le gustan esos topics, allí en el manual también tiene un espacio para escribir otros tres topics. ¿Sí?
Por ejemplo, a mí me encanta hablar de política. Yo sé, pero no estoy hablando de la política partidaria, pero a mí me encanta hablar de discutir sobre la situación, la política y todo eso, pero no muchas personas les gusta.
That's good. You can go check, right, and talk about that too. Mm-hmm. Yes, why not?
De la selecta.
Ajá.
Hablemos de la selecta, pues.
Ajá, de fútbol.
You can talk about sports or soccer in particular, soccer, right? Ajá. Ask the questions, discuss the questions with your partners. And feel free to give your answers, right?
Dice, one question.
For your habits, for example, this is the day, the first day that I meet you. So you're going to say, hi, Anna. I don't take a bath every day. I'm just taking a bath once a week.
Yes. Hi, teacher.
Hi.
Teacher, acá. Nosotros nos pusimos a hablar acerca de temas apropiados e inapropiados, pero no era hacer nosotros una conversación.
No, todavía no. Al final.
Tiene que ser general ahorita, de lo ahorita que consideremos apropiado.
Exacto. Okay. De hecho, si no le gustan esos topics, pueden ir escribiendo otros tres acá. And discuss about them.
Estamos hablando de religión, teacher. Inapropiado.
Religion. Oh, yeah.
She said too that clubs about sports, clubs topic.
Do you think it is a good idea to talk about soccer?
No. All right. No, it's a good idea.
So people can feel like angry, right? If you don't like the same ones that they do,
more if they are of Alianza clubs,
Real Madrid y Barcelona, right?
It's a select the ¿cómo es? La selecta que está jugando ahorita, por ejemplo.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Los hombres no están poniendo atención a la clase, teacher.
Sí, grabar, teacher.
Are you playing today against Jamaica? No. ¿O against who?
El Salvador, Jamaica.
Salvador, Jamaica, right?
Yes.
Predictions. Jamaica. Vaya, you can make your predictions. Who do you think?
Who do you think? Of course.
Okay.
Sí, pero El Salvador.
Mira, ya salió Yuri del estudio.
Zero. Yeah. Zero. Yo estoy llorando. Qué barbaridad.
And they're about to finish. No, right? Not yet.
No.
Not yet.
So hopefully they have time. They have time.
At 8 p.m. So maybe they are in the half time.
So they will be finishing by the time we finish class.
Yes.
Okay. We can always watch the repetition, right? We can always watch. If it was a good game, we can see it, but if they lose me, it's like, I know.
Yes. No, thank you.
Okay, I leave you for you to continue talking.
Wait. Vamos. Hi, teacher.
Ay, porque están escondidos ustedes.
Ah. Dice que estamos aquí con la duda de que, por ejemplo, no sé si estamos bien. Por ejemplo, nosotros el primer tópico hemos pensado en comida.
Delicious.
Ajá, entonces, no sé si ya la parte 4, por ejemplo, le hemos adaptado. Que dice, excuse me, where is the restaurant?
Ah, todavía no se vayan a la conversación. Ahorita preguntas así al azar.
Ah, ok.
Sí, ahorita nos vamos a quedar así con preguntas al azar y más tardecito vamos a venir a hacer la conversation.
Ah, ok, entonces nos quedamos con el paso 3 nada más.
Exacto. Ya tienen los topics, discuss questions about the topics. Pueden discutir algunas de las preguntas que están dadas también allí, ¿verdad?
Ah, ok, ajá, referente a los nuevos tópicos.
Exacto.
Ok. Bueno, entonces vamos
más adelantito nos vamos a ir al small talk que ustedes van a hacer.
Ah, va. De acuerdo. Entonces vamos a buscar las preguntas.
Perfect.
Great.
Ya.
Teacher, no sé qué actividad estaban haciendo.
Dani, we were doing in the manual page 25, activity 2.
No sé qué es lo que tenían que hacer.
Check the exercise. Ya está en el exercise. You have to...
Page 22.
No, 25. Right now, your partners were discussing questions about these topics.
Okay. Mm-hmm. O sea, que hay que elegir cuáles son las correctas, las que creemos que son correctas, ponerles cheque, y las que creemos que son equivocadas, ponerles cruz.
Exacto.
Okay. Vaya.
Nice.
Es que me sacó de la clase esta cosa, no sé por qué.
Y yo la estuve llamando, pero no sé, no logró unirse al grupo, ¿verdad?
Ah, es que no me agarraba, no sé por qué. Me tocó reiniciar el teléfono en gran relajo.
Ay, no, qué tremendo. Pero qué bueno.
Sí, pero ya lo logré.
Vamos a ver, Ana Alicia. Ana Alicia.
Present.
Ángel.
Present, teacher.
Benjamin.
Present.
Carlos Ernesto.
Present.
Carolina. Carolina. Daniela María.
Present, teacher.
Nice. David Alexander.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Edwin. Edwin, Grace Mitchell.
Grace. Present, teacher.
Me gusta ese nombre, Grace.
Thank you, teacher.
Lástima que ya no tengo más niñas chiquitas, ¿verdad? Para ponerle otro nombre así bonito.
A los nietos.
Ay, sí, hombre, bye. Ya vamos a ir apuntando los nombres. Ay, de la paz. the
present teacher.
Excellent.
I'm here.
Excellent idea. Isabel? Isabel. Allí lo veo. Ok, great. Jonathan.
También del partido, teacher.
Present, teacher.
Ah, por eso no me contesta.
Qué buri.
Después
ya no es exhibir.
Después van a hacer una conversation de breaking the ice, hablando del partido. Ya van a ver. Jonathan.
Uno de los temas.
Los de la Coyuri. Jonathan.
Sorry.
Jonathan, no here. Había visto por allí. Juan Antonio. Karen.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Marina. Marina.
Teacher, aquí estoy, solo que estoy trabajando todavía.
Ah, vaya, vaya, estoy... vaya. Ahí está, muy bien. Marina. Marina. No. Marlene.
Present, teacher.
Teresa. De Jesús. Teresa de Jesús. Rosailda.
Present, teacher.
Walter. Walter. Yuri.
Present, teacher.
Aristides. Aristides no lo he visto ahora. Brenda Jamilet. Brenda. Luis Mauricio.
Present, teacher.
Jancy.
Present.
Okay, Teresa del Carmen. Teresa.
Ella publicó en el grupo que estaba algo malita aún por lo de la tercera dosis.
Una. Estaba una. Mucho suerito, acetaminofén y un montón de pastillas.
No, el ejercicio ayuda.
Ah, bueno, hay que ir a caminar al parque La Concordia.
Sí. Al parque La Concordia.
That's a good exercise.
Yes.
Okay, bueno, let's move to the next activity.
Okay. I know.
I know. I have some questions. I ya yo give back and thank you. Okay, check. Qué molesta esta teacher. Después le voy a hacer falta. Check this question. When do babies usually start talking? When do babies usually start talking? What's a small talk? What is etiquette? What do Neil and Rob talk about? Why do British ask about the weather to break the ice? What does the speaker do when he doesn't remember a person's name? Vaya, those are some of the questions that you will ask. Okay? Vamos a ver. Or you will answer. You're going to listen to me. Vamos a ver. Bueno, I'm going to stop sharing. Porque si no me dice Zoom que estoy compartiendo el WhatsApp. Regaña. Vale, aquí estamos. Check. Those are the questions you're going to answer. You're going to answer them. I'm going to read to you a script. Desafortunadamente. No podemos, no podemos usar material de terceros, así como para poner el audio, ¿verdad? Entonces van a escuchar mi bella voz. Yo les voy a leer el script de la conversación. ¿Ok? Ya, estamos listos. You have, I'm going to share again. Share the questions. You listen to me, right? You listen to the script and you will answer the questions. So we're talking about small talk, right? Small talk. Listen and answer. Hello, I'm Neil. Welcome to 6 Minute English and with me in the audio, in the studio, Rob. Hello, Neil. How are you today? I'm fine, thanks. How are you? I'm very well. Actually, the weather has been nice lately, hasn't it? Yes, it has. The winter has been mild this year, but according to the forecast, there might be some snow in parts of the country next week. And you know, that's good because I love snow and we haven't seen much of it for quite a while. It's only rain, isn't it? Okay, enough. Enough now, or they're going to think it's true that British people only talk about the weather, right? In this program, we're talking about conversation and how to start talking with people you don't know. In short, how to make a small talk, right? Well, small talk is what we call a polite and informal conversation about things which aren't really important or meaningful when meeting people socially, like at a party, for example. And in this program, you'll learn some vocabulary about communication. But first, a question. Rob, when do babies usually start talking? Is it when they are 9 months, 16 months, or 18 months? Well, I think they start making noises at quite an early age. And I guess if that's talking, let me say 9 months. Okay, well, we'll have the answer to that question at the end of the program. Small talk is a social skill. Some people feel awkward. It means they feel uncomfortable or embarrassed when they go to a party and don't know many people there. Like Richard Ziegler, the author of The Ultimate Guide to Party Planning and Etiquette, knows a lot about what to do on these occasions. Etiquette is the set of rules which indicate what behavior in a society is acceptable and what is not. Yes, the author knows a lot about etiquette. Let's listen to her advice. What expressions does she use to describe the act of attempting to start a conversation with someone? Liz Brewer, author of Ultimate Guide to Planning and Etiquette. You walk into a room, there is a sea of faces. Well, the first thing we do is, it's the weather. We do it because we aren't in fact breaking the ice. That is a call. That means I want to talk to you. It's an easy subject. It's not too penetrating. We're very private people. We don't like to give too much information. So we are on safe ground. We start off with the weather. If that goes well, we then take it one step further. Liz Brewer talks about breaking the ice. It means approaching someone you don't know and starting a friendly conversation with them. And when you break the ice, talking about things which are not specific in the best way, you don't start a chat asking straight away where people live or what they do for a living. And as the author said, we are very private people. Private describes somebody who doesn't like to give away their personal information, opinions, or share their feelings. So we need more time to open up to people we have just met. Good. So now you know what to do at a party when you don't know the other guests. But Neil, there is one particular situation I'm not sure how to deal with. This is when I forget the name of the person. I've been making small talk with. Yes, I know what that's like. You might not feel comfortable about allowing the person to realize you didn't really catch their name. It might sound rude. Yes, that's right. I don't want to sound rude, which means ill-mannered or unpleasant. The person I've just managed to approach might think I don't care. Let's see what tip author on etiquette Liz Brewer has for us. Which words does she use instead of I have for Karen? Liz Brewer, author of The Ultimate Guide to Planning and Etiquette. You can say, oh, just your name, it has just slipped my mind for the moment. And they say, Paul, you say, oh, no, 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 I know you're Paul. It was the surname. Or they give you the surname and then you add the other. As I say, small talk is a call towards getting information and going further. Once you feel comfortable, then you can have these wonderful in-depth conversations. Those are the kinds of things you want to probably do later. Liz Brewer says, your name has just slipped my mind. It's a gentler way of saying they have just forgotten the person's name. I'm pretending that you knew the person's name, but you want the other name is a clever trick. Yes, it might sound like you forgot the name, but not completely. And this author shows that you have to interact with people in a charming way. Yes, well, my co-presenter, just your name has just slipped my mind for the moment. Come on, Rob, you know it's Neil. Yes, it's Neil. I'm just practicing my social skills there. Well, I'm afraid you have to practice some other time because, well, I don't want to sound rude, but we are running out of time. Let me give you the correct answer to the quiz question now. Yes, you asked me, when do babies usually start talking? And you gave me three options. Yes, the options were 9 months, 6 months, or 18 months. And I went for the first one, 9 months. Was I right? You were wrong. The correct answer was 18 months. Now, according to the website webmd.com, there are some milestones in speech development. At 6 months, your baby begins babbling with different sounds. For example, your baby may say baba or dada. And then after that, at 9 months, babies can understand a few basic words. At the age of 18 months, babies say up to 10 simple words. Ah, interesting stuff. And we're still learning words now, aren't we? We are. Well, enough. Enough of this talk. Let's remember some of the words we used today, Rob. They were small talk, awkward, etiquette, breaking the ice, private, rude, slip my mind. That's it for the program. And go to the Give a website for learning more. Bye-bye. Bye. Okay, that was the small talk was not that small, right? But if you see it, there were a couple of tips. There were a couple of tips for you to get to know what to do with breaking the ice. So I have some questions here and I hope you got the answers, right? When do babies usually start talking? What's a small talk? What's etiquette? What do Neil and Rob talk about? Why do British ask about the weather to break the ice? What does the speaker do when he doesn't remember a person's name? According to the woman, what was her name? I forgot. What was the name of the woman, the one they interviewed? Liz Brewer. Well, they don't interview Liz Brewer, but they mention Liz Brewer. She's talking about etiquette, right? So what does she say that you should do when you forget the person's name? And why does she say that British talk about the weather? Okay, I'm going to send you to the rooms for you to go share with your partners the answers for these questions, which ones you answer, which ones you can need a little help from your partners. You go ahead. Let's see, I'm going to send you, I'm going to really make the groups. I'm going to remake the group so you go discuss with your partners. There you go. Remember, discuss the groups, the questions. I already sent to you the questions to the WhatsApp group. Try to join. Try to join. I did. Benjamin, Jonathan is still working.
Ahí está la
teacher.
No entendimos.
I have a question.
Tell me.
Answer the question about the talk
yeah. That I was reading.
Okay. Okay, I don't remember four.
Maybe you remember two, your partners remember the other two, so if between all, you can make everything. And don't worry about being very exact, right? I know it's not the same when you listen to the original audio than when you listen to one person making all the voices. It's totally different.
Okay. And we are trying the answer the question.
Okay, perfect. That's the idea, right?
Okay. Vale, Charlie, te voy a compartir entonces para que.
Ese mundo está en sintonía.
Ya.
Ya, vaya. Espérame que se me queme el pan.
Ay, Dios, Mauricio. Teacher, póngale cero, está comiendo en clase.
Sí. Es un pequeño refrigerio.
Lo peor es que no comparte.
Exacto.
Sí,
exacto.
You have to share. Okay.
Okay.
Rosa is sharing. Okay, when do babies usually start talking? 6 months, according to the website.
Talking, no bubbling.
Uh-huh.
Sí.
Uh-huh. Sí, recuerdo que decía 17 meses, algo así, ¿verdad? Que comenzaban a hablar.
Very close.
De... Teacher no lo puede volver a leer.
Yes, teacher, application.
I'm going to give you just the options. The options were 9, 16, or 18 months.
16.
Es que según dijo, según lo que escuché y recuerdo, dijo que a los 9 meses ya tenían cierto conocimiento de. Entonces, está entre 8 y 6.
¿Cómo estamos nosotros con vos aquí?
No, dijo 11 meses, no. 11 meses, no.
No, that was not an option. The options were, a ver, 16, no, 9, 16, 18.
Okay.
Check. He says, according to the website, There are some milestones in speech development. At 6 months, your baby begins babbling. So blah, blah, blah. Dada, baba. But that's not talking. That's
oh.
Not talking. No, that's no, not talking.
Did it. So that is just confused.
Dada.
I listened to the deep part.
And after that, at 9 months, babies start to understand, but they still say nothing. At the age of 18 months, babies is... No sé si está hablando con nosotros, Aide, o con alguien más.
No sé qué está peleando.
Está peleando ahí, por allá.
Perdón.
Desactive el audio ahí para pelear.
Oye, cierre el audio y vaya a pelear, Dennis. Okay. So you see? Did you listen to what I read? Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Entonces es 18 months.
18. Yeah.
18 months. The first is 18.
¿Qué día sería?
No, por ti, pero es diferente.
Dani.
Casi no le escucho.
Dani.
Hola.
¿Dónde anda?
Aquí estoy. Lo que pasa es que estoy viendo la pantalla. Ay.
Ah, ya
aquí estoy.
Escondida.
La pantalla.
Yo. Okay, how are you doing with the questions there? ¿Cómo van?
No hemos avanzado mucho, teacher.
Okay.
Perdón.
A ver, chicken.
Mira, yo no sé.
An informal conversation about things which aren't really important or meaningful when meeting people socially.
Get that.
Lo veo en la segunda.
¿Cómo se dio ahí?
Yo creo que el compañero no me escucha.
Ahí está Benjamin.
El number one, Daniela. Is
nice move.
He said
since 9 months, pero no sé si es la respuesta correcta, como lo repito.
¿Cómo, Daniela?
Desde los 9 meses. En la primera.
O sea, pero sí. No,
since es desde, pero en la segunda no sé.
Dice que pequeña charla.
¿Qué es una pequeña charla? What's a small talk?
Es que tenemos aquí a la teacher que nos repita todo el día.
Sí, ¿verdad?
¿Cómo es? ¿Qué es una pequeña charla?
Sería bueno.
¿O solo le ponemos yes?
No, porque te está preguntando qué es. Ah, no es una pregunta de yes, no.
Sí, sorry. problema.
Pero es en base a la, al diálogo.
Al diálogo, ajá.
No
pero que era mucha información.
Very long. I know it was very, very long.
Sí, definitivamente.
Finish.
Teacher. Hello.
Ahí viene la teacher.
You save me.
Did you finish? Yes.
Estamos perdidos.
No.
A ver.
En todo, teacher.
¿Dónde andan?
Bring me the life. Teacher.
Sí, teacher, para serle sincero, prácticamente no logramos comprender la conversación.
No captamos las preguntas.
¿Cuándo
Neil and Rob talk about? ¿De qué están hablando Neil and Rob?
De todo un poco.
Pero, o sea, el topic así en general, ¿de qué era? Porque algunas cosas de las que ellos hablan hacia el azar son muestras de qué.
De temas de conversación, ¿no?
Small talk.
How do you call? Small talk.
Wow. Okay, the answer is in the question.
Always.
Yes.
Remember that. Yeah.
Teacher, do you repeat conversation?
It was very long. Very. Pero allí yo les voy a dejar de tarea que le den click al link de la página 25 para que lo logren escuchar completo y con dos voces diferentes o tres.
Ok.
Yo le estaba sugiriendo al teacher ver la clase en repetición y ir escuchando la pausa para aprovecharla, porque honestamente no comprendí mucho.
Ya le voy a mostrar. Check, ¿qué es este? Es este link el que le estaba leyendo, pero como por cuestiones de que no podemos compartir cosas de terceros, ¿verdad? Pero las instrucciones eran que se las leyera yo. Pero ustedes ya en su tiempo aparte pueden irse a este link y ahí van a ir escuchando y pueden ir leyendo el script. Y así se
les va mucho más
fácil. Ahí, page 25 en el
material.
Ajá, page 25.
Ah.
Es la page
Yo esperaba 25. Verlo que lo compartiera.
Ahí está en el manual.
Teacher, yo le voy a ser sincera. Una vez intenté ingresar a esos enlaces y no pude. Y es que usted nos está diciendo,
lo hizo desde el teléfono.
Sí.
Porque en el teléfono creo que no se puede, pero desde la computadora sí.
Y en todo caso, tendría que copiarlo el link. Y luego pegarlo en Google.
No, pero desde la computadora sí se puede. Porque
sí, solo que en la computadora. Bueno, ok. Sí, es solo que en el trabajo le han muteado los sonidos. Entonces,
desde la computadora, copie el link, pégueselo en WhatsApp y ya lo puede oír abrir ya en el teléfono.
Okay.
Se puede intentar ahorita.
Thank you, teacher. Sí, intenten, porque si no, yo me salgo de aquí y no sigo en la clase.
Yo no tengo tu
lección. No, después, mañana, en un ratito que vaya manejando, ahí puedo escuchando. Sí, pues.
¿Cuándo manejo?
La práctica, remember. Vale, yo me lo llevo ya.
Okay.
Ok. Vamos a ver. How many are here? Okay.
No, teacher, qué barbaridad. Acaban de dañarme ahorita.
Cuando quedó solito, qué tremendo.
Me dejaron, para empezar me dejaron solo y para terminar me dieron una cosa.
Eso fue por no compartir.
De los grupos.
Sí, sí, cabal, eso fue.
Mi Luis.
Chave, vaya, tell me, what do babies usually, when do babies usually start talking? According to the conversation, right?
18 months.
Yes, when they are 18 months.
We thought that 9 months because they start to say blah, 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 things like that. Hmm.
But that's not
baby understand.
Uh-huh. according to the website, it said that at the 6 months they start with dada baba, but they say nothing. Porque qué dada, qué baba. Right? But talking, well, when they are 9, they start understanding. They understand, but they still don't talk. And they start talking allá, cuando ya van a los 18 meses, empiezan a, allá van utilizando por lo menos, dice, 10 palabras. Pero allá, right? So imagine 1 year and a half. Y ustedes dicen, ¿y por qué yo no puedo hablar ya? Sí. It's little by little, right? Little by little, así como aprendimos a hablar a los inicios, así empezamos a ir hablando el idioma español, nuestro nativo, así igual vamos en un proceso en el idioma inglés. Right? That's a process. A ver, what's a small talk? What's a small talk?
According to the conversation.
Yes.
It's a polite conversation.
It's a polite conversation. Is it formal?
Maybe.
Usually it's informal, right? A small talk is informal. Mm-hmm. Y se llama small talk porque lleva una pregunta, una respuesta. Y a veces lo mucho, una pregunta, una respuesta y un rebote de pregunta y otra respuesta. Así lo mucho, right? Because it's a small talk. Okay, what is etiquette? What is etiquette?
I think socially skillful.
Yeah. The rules that the society gives us, right? To what is good, what is not good.
Yeah.
Related to behavior. Okay, what do Neil and Rob talk about? What do they talk about?
I don't remember.
What are they talking about in the whole thing?
Yeah.
In general, ¿cuál era el topic? Ellos hablaron de montón de cosas, pero in general, ¿cuál era el topic?
I think they were.
This one was the topic. They wanted to give you examples on how to make small talks.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Y por eso es que como small talk, un small talk fue hablar de babies. ¿Verdad? Que,
yeah.
How old do babies start talking? That's to break the ice. Another yes. One was about the weather.
The weather. Yes, because he says weather is later in the conversation.
Uh-huh. And why do the British ask the weather to ask about the weather to break the ice? Why?
This part don't listen. And I don't remember.
Why do British ask about the weather? Así en sus propias palabras, no me relaten todo lo que decía la conversation. Pero why do British ask about the weather?
To break because back? It is a common conversation.
Mm-hmm. It's common, right? And remember, private. Yeah? Private. Remember the word private. So they said it's general, it's a common topic. So if the conversation goes good, it's like, okay, we can talk about something else. If no, The idea here is to say, hey, quiero hablar contigo. Por eso te pregunto sobre el clima. Uh-huh. Right? But I don't want to say, to go to direct saying, what's your name? Where do you live? Because of course, the person will look at you like, yes. Right? I will move immediately. Right?
Yes.
I will move immediately. But if you start talking about the weather, it's like,
it's safe. Eso fue lo que sucedió conmigo. Definitivamente me dijeron, no, nos vamos, y se fueron.
Because you started asking other things, not about yes. the weather, you see. So you have to think about that. Yes. Okay. And at the end, what does the speaker do when he doesn't remember a person's name? You're talking with someone, you don't remember the person's name, and then what do? What do you do if you don't remember the person's name? Yo le cambio el nombre de repente a ustedes.
That you said was slipped my mind, but I don't understand what is the meaning.
Se me olvidó. Por ejemplo, se acuerda del nombre, pero no del apellido, o del apellido, pero no el nombre. Entonces le dice, you are Paul.
Se recuerda de la farmacia.
My mind. Se me olvidó. Ay, se me olvidó, no me acuerdo de qué. ¿Por qué? Right? So you say, you are, it slipped my mind, no me acuerdo, right? Then the person says, Paul, yes, you're Paul. Cuando la persona le está diciendo el nombre, está diciendo, yes, you're Paul, porque ya le dijo, right? Okay, so he says, remember, you cannot, it's rude. Right, if you say like, se me olvida cómo se llamaba, right? And you can look good, or you can look rude if you don't remember what the person said, or what or the person's name. Now, look at this. I'm going to share a mini conversation, or a mini talk, a talk. Because now it's your turn for you to create your own. I check this one first. Vamos a ver. Check. Here we have a model. Recuerden hoy porque es tan chiquita la conversation, porque es una small talk. Y por eso se llama small talk, porque es chiquita. Y el propósito solo es romper el hielo y ya. No llevar una gran conversación, como que si ya conoce la persona, ya de ahí puede salir una conversación enorme, ¿verdad? Pero empezamos con algo chiquito. And check the example. Excuse me, where is the conference? It's on the second floor. Thanks. By the way, are you attending too? Yes, I am. Esta conversación me recuerda allá. Por los 1987 más o menos. I remember I was walking
I met another girl with the same uniform that I was wearing. And she talked to me and she said, are you going to the institute? And I said, yes, and you? Yeah, me too. I'm going to the institute too. What are you going to study? I'm going to study to be a secretary, secretariado comercial. And I was like, hey, me too. In what section are you? I am in section, ya ni me acuerdo cuál. But she said, ah, yeah, me too. So at the end, we were partners. And we became very good friends for the 3 years that we were studying at the institute. And even later, we still continued communicating with each other. But you see, we started like this with a mini talk because of the uniform, that we had something in common, right? Like, whoosh, long, long time ago. Her name is Margarita, by the way. I still remember the name. Imagine, ¿cuántos años pasaron? Como 30, ¿cuántos? A ver, ya no sé. Okay, but you see, that's easy way to make a small talk, right? Because what you want is just to start a conversation. That's the purpose of a small talk, to start a conversation. So here, what you're going to do is make three small talk questions. ¿Verdad? Three small talk questions. Tenemos una, podemos hablar del weather, podemos hablar de travel. Recuerden que ustedes hace un rato cuando los mandé a los grupos, escribieron tres temas que les gustaría hablar como small talk, ¿verdad? Entonces, ahorita yo los voy a dejar que me escriban. Por ejemplo, si tenemos the weather como topic, write in the chat one question that you could use to break the ice when talking about the weather. Or another question that you can use when talking about travel or talking about food, about any other, for example, if you say food.
I see food.
Pero recuerden que también si mi small talk va a ser sobre food, ¿cuál es el contexto donde estoy? ¿Estoy en una cafetería? ¿Estoy en un restaurante? Muy bien. Pero estoy a media clase, todo el mundo con hambre y empiezo a hablar de comida, qué triste. Lo van a ver así Mami. Como que, ¿verdad? ¿Qué te pasa?
So, Visto hasta aquí.
Entonces, check that too. ¿Ok? What other topic you mentioned there in your groups? Food, sports. I listened to some people saying sports. Yes. Sports in general, or you can say soccer. Right, pero cheque que soccer. Oh well, yeah, soccer, politics, and religion are three topics that sometimes. I don't have problems talking about politics, but there are some people that may feel like angry if you don't agree with their thoughts, right? So topics to be careful, right? But you can talk about hobbies. ¿Qué más? Dígame topics. What else?
Me say food.
What did you put?
Food, comida.
Aquí, food. Food, sports.
Music.
Music, yes, music. That's a very good topic, music.
Movies.
Movies too.
Culture, teacher.
Culture, yeah. Culture. Pongamos aquí arriba, culture. We're talking about food. I'm hungry porque tengo hambre. Culture. Ya ven por qué es mala idea hablar de comida. You feel hungry later. Okay, culture. So here you have some topics. Great questions. Great one question. One question over there.
en el chat. Aquí en el chat, chat, chat. No veo a nadie escribiendo yo en el chat. ¿En cuál chat te están escribiendo? ¿En el de WhatsApp? No. Aquí en el de Zoom. Ah, nice. What's your favorite food? Another question you could ask. Vamos, vamos, don't be shy. What's your favorite music? Any other? Vamos, vamos, vamos. Have you ever seen La Catedral de Mar serie? Is that a movie, Anna?
No, it's a serie.
Oh, sounds interesting. It's cold today, right? Huh? The weather, yeah. What's your favorite food? Yeah. Mother. What other questions? Do you like to dance? Ah, yes, I see. If you were in a party, right? If you're in a party, that's a good question. Okay, now you see there are some questions in the chat. Okay, do you like it? Of course, we like vacations. Which seasons of the year is your favorite? Nice. Who wins soccer? Hey, who won? It hasn't finished yet? No. Has the match finished? Yeah, it finished.
Yes, yes.
Who won?
Nobody.
Oh, it was tied. That's what you say, tied. Tied. T-I-E-D, when they... Jamaica won, says Isabel.
No, 1-1.
1-1? 1-1, yes. Okay, so they are tied up, tied. What's your favorite place in Salvador? Nice, yes. What's your favorite? Do you have a car? Hey, nobody asks about animals. What's your favorite animal? Do you have a pet? Where you go? Where do you go on vacation? Where do you go on vacation? Okay, I will need 2 volunteers. Or victims, Angel and Anna. Choose one topic and make a small talk.
What topic do you want? Angel, culture, food, sports, hobbies, music, movies.
Food.
Who will break the ice? Well, I need a volunteer. Who will break the ice?
Hey, Angel, did you just say no?
Did you have dinner already?
Okay. Yes, I did dinner. I don't know what to say. I ate dinner tonight.
Before class? No.
During yes, class. Before class.
In the middle of the class.
What's your favorite dessert for the night?
For the night, dessert.
Yes, perdón, dessert or dessert.
Favorite dessert is
a dessert and pie is a dessert.
Okay. Cookies.
After,
yes, maybe sometimes I eat a little piece of bread or one a cookie, or I drink a little glass of milk.
Yeah. Hot or cold?
No, cold.
Cold.
Yes. And you?
Okay. A little cup of tea.
Oh yeah, like a teacher.
Yes.
Yes,
today
it okay. Was coffee.
Oh, today this coffee. Because tomorrow is Saturday and the body knows.
Nobody knows that I work all day tomorrow.
Thank you, Angel.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank
very
you.
Good. Angel, choose a person, and Anna will choose another one.
Thank you, teacher. Thank you. I choose Luis because he have many conversation. No, muchas ganas. I don't know.
Okay, Angel, Luis, and Anna chose. Benjamin.
De que se le quiten las ganas de hablar a Luis.
Okay, perfect. Benjamin no. And Luis.
I don't speak. I didn't speak.
Benjamin, where are you?
Por eso que no es martes y no ha pensado en el tequila, va.
Yes. Hey,
Benjamin, who will begin? Benjamin o Luis?
Also, I started the okay. Conversation.
Qué raro.
This is rarely.
Begin, Luis.
Yes, okay. Benjamin, how are you? In your department is a cold or hot? or this a warm.
What's the weather like where you live?
What's
the weather like where you live?
Where are you from? Where are you from, Benjamin?
It's the vida personal. That's not valid.
In the Sultan.
Ah, it's a warm place.
Mm-hmm.
Probably, well, because the time is changed. Okay, what do you like? Why do you light in the night or another?
Focus, Luis, focus. No me rebote de un tema a otro, focus.
Okay.
Si no, lo que va a pasar es que el amigo que quiere hacer se le va a escurrir.
Yes, Benjamin.
Se le van los clientes.
Se me fueron los clientes.
Ahí es donde pierde el cliente, ahí en la farmacia.
Imagínense.
You have to focus on a topic. You're talking about the weather, focus on the weather, right?
Okay. Yeah. But it's a functional in the pharmacy.
Because they urge the medicine.
Yes.
Okay, very good.
Okay, Benjamin. Sorry.
Sorry, Liz.
Yeah, be careful. Be careful that when you are in a small talk, as you are breaking the ice, remember one important thing is don't jump to the personal, right?
Okay.
Private. Remember, one clue is private. And that's why there are some topics that you can use, like to tell the person, hey, I want to talk to you, but without saying what's your name, where do you live, what's your doing number, and what's your Facebook and your WhatsApp, right? So just keeping a distance, but trying to get a communication started, right? Once the conversation goes, then you can start asking something more personal. But at the beginning, be like, watch out, right? So watch out.
Oh.
Ask about, if you ask, for example, about the weather, is it very hot where you live? And if the person says, well, kind of. And what about the rest of the year? Y si usted ya le preguntó que cómo está el clima el resto del año, vaya haciéndose la idea de más o menos por dónde vive. Le dice, yes, right now the weather is nice, but during the rest of the year, in March, April, it is very hot. So where do you live? Do you live in San Miguel? And they will tell you, no, I live in Usulután. O sea, poquito a poquito, sacando la
información. La información.
Yeah. Keep it like private, right? Remember? Bueno, que aquí en El Salvador medio le preguntan y la gente le dice.
Yes. Yeah, the,
yeah. Right?
Yo estoy de acá.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Well, but checking. En el discussion, le voy a poner, y es para que vayan pensando y empiecen a escribir, ¿verdad? Le voy a poner que me escriba un small talk. Usted decida sobre qué topic lo quiere hacer, ¿verdad? Ahí me va a escribir un small talk in the discussion. Así que se los pongo otro ratito. Well, let's see. ¿Quién se va a quedar conmigo hoy? Vamos a ver. Viernes 12, Grace Michelle. Grace Michelle. Bacha. Let's go to the attendance. Ready. Buen provecho. Ana Alicia.
Present.
Ángel.
Present.
Benjamin.
Present.
Carlos Ernesto.
Present.
Carolina. Daniela.
Present, teacher.
Okay, David. David.
Present, teacher.
Edwin. Grace Michelle.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Aide de la Paz.
Present, teacher.
Isabel.
Present, teacher. Present.
Hoy sí, ya la oí. Isabel. Isabel.
Present, teacher.
Good. Jonathan.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Juan Antonio. Juan. Okay. Karen.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Marina, Vanessa. No. Marlene.
Rosa. Present, teacher.
Eso. Rosa Hilda.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Teresa de Jesús. Teresa de Jesús. Walter. ¿Verdad que sí estaba Teresa de Jesús? Esa se acaba de salir. Walter. Yuri.
Present, teacher.
Okay, very good, Judy. Aristides. Brenda. Mauricio.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Teresa del Carmen. Y Jancy.
Present.
Excellent. Okay, very good.
Teacher. No se quemaron los panes, quedaron ricos.
Ah, no, están quemados, así están bien, más crudos, ¿no?
No, están súper ricos.
Con mantequilla.
Exacto.
Con miel. Con miel.
Sí, con miel.
Ay. Mermelada de fresa.
Sí, no, súper rico.
Le están dando, dicha.
Con crema de maní. Ya voy a buscar, yo se me han dejado pan tostado todavía.
Sí.
Okay. Bueno, it was a pleasure to be with you today.
Yeah.
See you Monday.
See you Monday.
Enjoy. Happy weekend.
God bless you, everybody. Teacher.
Bye.
Yes, teacher.
Excellent.
Ay, me dejaron el fan encendido. A ver, cuénteme. Do you have any question? No le oigo, tiene cerrado el micrófono.
Ay, perdón. Creí que ya había abierto. Pues no tengo muchas preguntas, pero sí, bueno, estoy aprendiendo bastante. Lo único que me cuesta todavía hablar fluido en el inglés. Pues veo que varios compañeros aquí ya lo hablan más fluido.
Sí, lo que pasa es que algunos ya han estudiado antes también, ¿verdad? Y vienen desde el principio, pero ya venían así como con una base también.
Uh-huh. Pero bien, yo he estudiado, pero nunca lo he practicado como de corrido tanto. Mantener una conversación más del what is your favorite color, animal, y no sé qué, así como lo que estamos practicando hoy. Uh-huh,
uh-huh.
Es como
sí,
que...
pero es bien importante soltarse. Y fíjense que por eso es que me gusta mandarlos a los grupos chiquitos, porque ahí es como que... como es más pequeño, ¿verdad? Menos pena de que, ay, se me voy a equivocar, ¿y qué digo?
Entonces, o por lo menos puedes hablar más con una persona.
Exacto, le da un poquito más de confianza, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Y sí, es bien importante el soltarse a hablar, y si se equivoca, no importa, ¿verdad? Eso
sí,
es
parte más que todo.
Aprendizaje.
Pensar en inglés, no en español, porque tal vez uno en español lo sabe decir, pero en inglés cuesta.
Sí, realmente eso es bien importante, la forma en que puede conseguir, ¿verdad? Ir pensando en inglés es exponerse un poquito más al idioma, ¿verdad? Empezar a escuchar un poquito más, a leer un poquito más. Hay links, ¿verdad? Que le pueden ayudar con respecto al audio. Y con respecto a historias cortas, para poder ir reforzando un poquitito más y agarrar un poquito más de confianza. Y si usted se fija también al final de cada primera página del libro,
sí,
hay links que se pueden utilizar, ¿verdad? A veces tiene que darle control click o copiar todo el link e irlo a pegar al browser, para poder hacer uso de él y poder seguirlo, pero le ayuda a reforzar porque ahí hay readings, hay algunos que son ejercicios de gramática y hay otros que son listenings. Por ejemplo, el que les puse hoy, bueno, el que les estuve leyendo yo.
Lo leyó, sí.
A ese lo leí porque por cuestiones de derecho de autor no podemos poner el audio directo de YouTube, ¿verdad? Pero, ajá. Si usted le da clic, por ejemplo, acá está. Vamos a ver este. Si usted le da clic al link, puede perfectamente escuchar. Y ahí está el script que yo les leí también.
Oh.
Este otro, si no me equivoco, también es un listening. Sí, generalmente cuando le aparece esto, es un listening, ¿verdad? Entonces, ir escuchando estas cosas que están así que relacionadas con lo que se estuvo viendo en clase, le puede dar también un extra, ¿verdad? Un extra,
okay,
para ir fortaleciendo el área del oído que está muy conectada con el speaking.
Sí, yo lo que he tratado de hacer más o menos es ir viendo series en inglés,
¿sí?,
para poder ir... tratando de escuchar algunas palabras, sí las identifico, pero con lo mismo a uno le da, siento que escuchar el inglés sí te dan ganas de hablar, o sea,
exacto,
tienes ganas como que las palabras que escuchaste en el audio, en la película, lo que sea, lo querés decir.
Uh-huh. Exacto, exacto. Uh-huh. Y que fíjense que realmente está conectado el audio con el speaking y el reading con el writing. Entonces, por ejemplo, sí, dice, a mí me cuesta orientarme o coordinarme para escribir preguntas o para escribir algo en inglés. Entonces, lo que le conviene es leer, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Irse un poquito más a la lectura y eso le va a ayudar a formar las oraciones cuando necesite escribir. Y así igual, cuando lo que quieres aprender un poquito más de fluidez, eso entra por acá.
Oh.
A escuchar un poquito más, a exponerse un poquitito más, y eso le va a ir ayudando a dar la pausa para el speaking.
Entonces, para hablar.
Conectados, listening con speaking y reading con el writing.
Ok.
Así va.
Sí, no sabía eso, pero sí lo voy a practicar porque...
Sí, ahí depende.
Una técnica.
Sí, porque, por ejemplo, vaya, en internet usted puede poner algún audio y lo puede ir repitiendo.
Ajá, sí.
Repitiendo, puede ir practicando. Hay también hay apps que le ayudan a ir interactuando.
Sí, yo estaba antes y jugaba con una que se llama Duolingo.
Ajá. Uh-huh.
Con ella cumplía las metas y eso. Luego el teléfono que tenía se me arruinó. Y ya en este nuevo ya no lo descargué de nuevo. Pero sí cumplía las metas diarias.
Sí, le ayuda bastante. Y para ir aprendiendo vocabulario, ir aprendiendo estructura y va llevando todo a la par. ¿Verdad?
Sí, sí.
Eso le puede dar un extra. Las clases, lo que va trabajando en la plataforma, lo que va... aprendiendo aparte y darle el extra, ¿verdad? Y depende qué tanto usted quiere aprender, es la exposición que necesita darle al idioma, ¿verdad?
Sí, sí, verdaderamente sí. Y es que es bien interesante, todo lo que vemos ya ahorita, ya este módulo lo siento más como enfocado a la profesión, ya más enfocado como al tecnicismo, de mantener una conversación de trabajo.
Exacto, exacto. Ya este uh-huh. va un poquitito más avanzado.
¿Verdad? Sí.
Más avanzado, ya sí. Va más enfocado al área de trabajo.
Sí. Sí.
La idea es que les vaya ayudando en el desempeño diario, ¿verdad? Que ustedes tienen en su trabajo.
Correcto. Uh-huh. Pero sí, muy buena temática. Y me gusta cómo trabajamos en pequeños grupos, aunque a veces pues yo vengo de trabajar o vengo corriendo y siempre hay un montón de cosas que hacer. Entonces por eso a veces me distraigo un poco de la clase, pero sí siempre estoy tratando de prestar toda la atención que puedo.
Sí, si le quedara chance el día siguiente, puede también ver alguna parte de la clase que de repente siente que se le quedó, ¿verdad? Para reforzar
también.
Los videos sí. Los van subiendo a diario allí a la plataforma.
Sí, así me fijé cuando hice la tarea. Solo que me dijo que me faltaban tres. Voy a revisar ahorita que terminemos.
La de ayer, la de hoy y la de lunes.
Ah, vaya.
La de ayer, la de hoy y la de lunes, que es que son las que van para la unidad 2.
Ah, vaya. Sí, porque yo dije, ayer me puse al día con todas hasta la de, creo que la anterior, la de ayer la iba a hacer supuestamente después de la clase, pero ya no la hice, pero sí la voy a hacer ahora.
Ajá, pues sí.
La de ayer y la de ahora.
La de ayer y la de ahora, así ya el lunes solo le queda la de lunes y el examen.
Sí, ahí me salió que ya tenemos un examen, pero dije yo no voy a esperar porque no sé si es ahora el examen.
Sí, no, y el asunto es que a veces, por adelantarse, se puede quedar así como que ya a ver cómo era esto, porque no lo ha visto todavía, ¿verdad?
Correcto.
Entonces, es importante poder ir al día con todo para no atrasarse al final, porque es triste después quedarse con que, uy, me falta un montón.
Sí, no, yo no había podido ingresar a la plataforma porque no me agarraba el curso, o sea, no identificaba qué curso era el de nosotros. Entonces, ayer, no me acuerdo si fue ayer, hoy es viernes, no sé si fue ayer o el miércoles, que Carlos me ayudó a identificar cuál era el grupo para poder meterme, porque yo no había podido encontrarlo, lo buscaba y me aparecían un montón, pero ninguno coincidía con la fecha. Decía yo, no, ninguno es, decía, entonces no me podía meter tampoco a ninguno, hasta que él me dice, no, mire, no sé qué. Y ahí cabal en la primera clase estaba usted, entonces cabal con el video me identifiqué que ese era.
Ah, vaya, pues sí. así ya va logrando avanzar poquito a poco.
Sí. Sí.
No sé si tiene alguna otra pregunta, Grace.
Por el momento yo digo que no, teacher.
Ok, perfecto. Bueno, que pase un bonito fin de semana entonces. And see you Monday.
Ok, thank you, teacher. Good night.
You're welcome. Good night.